Alright guys, it is ramp season and I'm going to talk to you about how to find ramps and stay tuned towards the end because I got a pickle recipe for you for pickled ramps, but we're going to go through the process of finding them, where they grow and how to pick them and how to identify them. First off, we want to go straight towards hardwood, a hardwood forest, okay? I would look more for places that haven't been stripped of coal. Places that haven't been hit hard with timbering. You can see the hillside that I'm on, it's kind of sparse. Not a whole lot of, brush and stuff underneath. And we got all kinds of trees. We got oak, we have maple, we have cherry, we have ash, we have birch. We have, what else do we have here? Some hickory. Land that hasn't been disturbed. And what I mean by disturbed, where you don't have over harvesting of timber, where you have machines coming in all over the ground and just tearing up the soil and tearing up everything. You don't want to go to places that have been stripped with coal because they're basically taking all the soil and flipping it up over. Where the logging has been, it's been done sparsely. And not over harvesting where, like I said, that there's not that much machinery. So this is, there's lots of rocks in here. So there hasn't been, the last time this was actually timbered was probably back in the late 30s or early 40s. You can see that we have lots of good leaf litter. We have a good canopy, okay? And that's what these ramps like to grow in. They like to grow in where it's not too much sun, not too much shade. So we have the hemlocks, and usually the hemlocks and stuff, they grow down along the bottom in the valleys. So you want to stay away from conifers, stay away from your pine trees and spruce trees and hemlocks. You usually find the ramps like in the mountainous places up on the hillsides, because usually where there's lots of people, doesn't mean that if you don't find any, doesn't mean that they didn't grow there. It could have been from over harvesting. Ramps are very susceptible to over harvest. So you only want to take a little bit. And the few patches that are still out there, you want to be able to harvest sustainably so that you continually have a regeneration of ramps for the years to come. So what happens if you find a patch and you take them all, that's it. There's not going to be any more ramps coming back. I do know that this whole hillside used to be covered in ginseng. Ginseng also likes to grow typically in the same types of places as these ramps. There's no ginseng. It's been over harvested. It's the same thing. The ginseng is all gone. You can't find a plant on the property because it has, every last bit of it has been taken. But one of the best times to look for ramps is let's say the 1st of April. Now I'm in West Central Pennsylvania, and this is actually before things really start getting green, but I'm towards the end of April now making this video, but they will pop up even earlier. One of the first things to come up out of the ground that are green, and they are very bright green. You will definitely notice them from a distance. And so what you want to do is just kind of just walk through the woods. Now, I found these in turkey season, but usually late May, they're pretty much done. But during our turkey season comes in around the 1st of May. And so that first week or so is a good time to look for them. But here is a small patch. Now, this was a white ash tree that I cut down because it was dead. And you can see out of everywhere, this is all the more there is. It is a very, very small patch. I mean, we're talking, 8 feet by 6 feet, maybe. That's it. And I have covered over 400 acres of the property. This is the only place that I have found where they're growing. So, I can look right out of my deer shanty up there, and, well, you're not going to see them come deer season anyways, because these will all be gone. But as you can tell, you can see how bright green they are, so they're very easy. But you have to know this one thing. There is a lookalike out there that will make you very sick. and that look-alike is called the Lily of the Valley. Now, there may be one or other two that you could say that are look-alikes, but when you go out to look for ramps, please do your research. Maybe get a wild edibles book of some sort and really study what the ramps look like. And now one of the easy things is they smell like onion and garlic. So that's an easy thing. But there are several lookalikes, and being like on social media, you'll see endless amounts of people who are constantly picking things that sort of resemble it. Could be flowers, it could be who knows what, and they think that they're ramps, and they're posting on the internet, hey, is this a ramp? Is this, you know, what it is? I don't know what it is. Can I eat this? Okay, we need to stop doing that, because number one, never rely on people on the internet to identify something that you're going to put in your mouth. Second, not that everyone's going to be wrong on the internet, but the problem is pictures are just, it's different with pictures than seeing in person. So most pictures could be trying to identify trees to even trying to identify ramps. There's some people that just put some really horrible pictures up there and expect people to know what it is. So again, we want to look for places where we have deciduous hardwoods. Okay, there's no pine needles or anything on the ground. This land has not been stripped of coal. The ground hasn't been disturbed. The last time that it was timbered, the timbering was always responsible timbering, and it's not like they're just tearing up the ground everywhere. And I don't know whether there have been over-harvests of ramps. Like I said, I do know that this hillside was over-harvested of ginseng, and ginseng is gone. I don't know if people were picking ramps on this hillside. This whole hillside, for all I know, could have been half covered with ginseng and half covered with ramps. I don't know. But when you find a patch like this, we need to learn how to harvest the best way. So here's the best way to harvest. First, you're going to need bring a knife. So this is just a little 2-inch Kershaw knife that I keep, pocket knife, you know. So you can use that. Sometimes you don't even need a knife, but you'll need like a little hand trough, little hand shovel or something to dig down. Now, I just have this little weird garden tool, and I sometimes carry this or a little, you know, hand trough, little hand shovel with me. But what we want to do is first figure out what you're going to use these for. You know, the whole plant is edible. The leaf is edible. People like to use them a lot, like in omelets and stuff like that, breakfast food and stuff like that. But you can also pickle them. That's what we're going to do. Now, for the pickling process, it is recommended that you pick the smaller of the ramps for the pickling process. But the problem is the smaller the bulb, and the smaller the plant, the more you have to pick to fill up the jar, you know, for the pickling. So that is all up onto you, whether towards the end, when we do the pickling recipe, whether you want to pick the biggest and fattest ones, or a mix of both, or just all small ones. And somebody's target practicing. So, no, this isn't somebody else's rampage and they're trying to scare me out. This is my property. Okay, so let's look at the plant. So as you can see, we have these big, nice green leaves. Now, there are other ones that have, as you notice, there's like a reddish stem, okay? But there are those that don't have the reddish stem, okay? Sometimes they can even grow in amongst the other ramps. Now, I am not seeing any that have just a solid green bottom, but there are ramps out there that do. So don't let that scare you if you see something that doesn't have a red stem, okay? Now, second, you can tell sometimes they'll have these little splits in the leaf. So you can see down here where the leaf has split, okay? So this is a small one, it has two leaves. Some of the bigger ones have three. This one here has three. Okay, now the best time to pick these is when they start coming up out of the ground. They're going to be pointed straight up in the air. Okay, so we want to try to pick them right when the tops start to bend over. So if you notice as we're looking, they're just coming up and just starting to lean over, okay? So that is when you want to pick them. So when they come up, constantly keep an eye out, because you're going to have a short period of time to harvest these, okay? So by most people, when they start thinking of them, it's usually mid-turkey season. They're out running the woods, and they might find them, and the patch is already gone. So like I said, I'm in West Central Pennsylvania, so we're looking at least the 1st of April. Now let's get into picking some. You want to take less than half of your pouch. If anything, try to take 25 to 30% of your patch, because these take a very long time to grow back and spread out. This patch has been here for several years, and it hasn't gotten much bigger than that. You might see some plants out there starting to grow, and you can see some little ones starting to come up right here. But I did have a tractor in here, and I knew these were in here, and I was cutting in the fall, and you couldn't tell where these were. I just knew the exact tree, but I wanted to make sure I didn't tear up the ground. So I tried to stay away from this area when I was cutting. But let's get into digging some of these up. So we'll start out here on the outside, just so that we're not trampling over a whole bunch of other ones. These go down pretty deep into the roots, and you can see the thickness of the soil. I mean, just rich organic matter, and that is a sign of ramps. They love this deep, thick organic matter on the hillsides. So I just like to cut away. Sometimes there's some roots of some other stuff in there. Usually if I'm going to take them whole, I'll just use a shovel and dig the whole way around them and pull the bulb and the roots and everything out. But here's how we're going to sustainably harvest these. So I'm going to try to get the camera down in here so you guys can see. I pushed the record button twice, so I just realized that. So I'm going to have to do this all over again. So this is what we're looking for, but we're going to do this again and show you how to do it. I got right down to where I was getting ready to cut, and then I ended up pushing the record button a second time. Okay, so again, we're going to just get this away. Sometimes they're not actually that deep. This isn't hard clay. It's not real packy stuff, but it's moist. And it's well drained, which means, you know, water, when it rains a lot, the ground is going to dissipate the water quickly, but it's going to retain its moisture. So that's the type of, you can see how thick the soil is. This is the type of stuff that these ramps like to grow in. We're getting down here. Now I'm just very lightly, now I'm not trying to go down deep to expose much of the roots. We don't want to expose too much of the roots. Okay, now this is how we're going to sustainably harvest these plants so that they come up next year. I'm gonna try to zoom in here. Now we get our knife, and we're just gonna follow the stem down to right when it starts to, let me try to scrape some of this off so you can see, right when the stem starts to flare out, we want to just kind of hold it right there. Now the bottom is just under the soil. We don't really want to be exposing too much of these roots, because you're going to cut them easily. But right down there is the root, so we want to look at halfway, judge halfway, and then come up just a little bit. So you're looking at just a quarter or a third of the way down the bulb. This is where you want to make your cut. So we're going to make our cut right here. Okay, now you can see how much of that bulb I have left in the ground. And there you can see how much I have remaining. So we're going to save that one. We're going to do that with these other two also. Pinch, just make an incision there. There's one. Let's see, we got one on this side. Okay, and one last one. Okay, so you can see that we left the roots intact. We didn't mess with them. We didn't pull them out of the ground. And we still have a lot still on these plants. Okay, so there. For all the more that took, you can see how quickly we got just a small handful. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to cover that back up. Next year, this will come back with ramps in the same place. So, if you were to pull the whole bulb and the root and everything out, that plant isn't going to come back next year. Now, don't let anybody tell you how to pick ramps. If you want to pull every single bulb out of your entire patch, that's up to you. Okay? And especially if it's on your own property. Okay? And now if you're on like on you know, public land or whatever, you know, look at the rules and the regulations, but try to sustainably harvest for others out there. But if you're on your own property and you want to pick every last one and not have any more grow on your property from forever, that's up to you. But if you want to pull some and you want to cut some, you know, that's up to you also. It does take a little bit of work, but then you're not having to wait a couple years for those ramps to grow out and fill back that what you harvested. So it's all a preference upon the person who is doing that. Even some people just like to eat the leaves, and they'll just cut the leaves off, and you don't have to dig around. Just cut the leaves off on the bottom, and they use the leaves for, you know, in other things like that. I'm going to tell you something else, that if you do find these, and a lot of people like to travel a good distance to find them, and when they find them, you know, you don't want to be telling anybody else where they're at, because, you know, other people, and it doesn't take very long to over-harvest. Try to look to see if other people have been in your patch. Sometimes it can be noticeable. And if that is, then you know that other people are harvesting from that also same patch, and you want to be careful. The best thing to do is to have more than one patch and to harvest from multiple patches in one season. So that's what I'm doing today. But another thing is, and this is going to be a little tip, you can transplant these. And they take off very well. If put in the proper place, you can have ramps right behind your house, pretty much if you have the right habitat. And, you know, it's going to take years for them to grow out. You just plant them and leave them be. It's sort of like people who plant ginseng. You plant ginseng, but it's going to take you a lot of years to have something worth harvesting. But then, you know, some people drive a long ways just to get some ramps. And I'm actually not that far from the house, but there's not a whole lot. So my parents have transplanted some, so we're going to go check out those. And I'm going to show you the other way to harvest, which is just kind of pulling the whole bulb and root out of the ground. And then again, stay tuned for that pickling recipe. All right, so I'm just going to show you the other way. If you're wanting to just harvest the entire bulb and everything, gonna scrape a lot of this leaf litter out. Okay, so we're gonna try to zoom in here so you can see exactly how I do this. So I just use this, cut the dirt, get the whole way around. You don't want to be pulling, you just want to have a light tension on it. You get to judge how deep you are. And there we go. So there is how you can do it the quick way. But again, now that I've done that, there's not going to be any ramps growing back in this particular spot after I did that, because I took the roots and everything. So again, it's up to you on how you harvest your ramps. Okay, there's after harvesting how much I got. This is actually a lot. I got quite a bit. I mean, it takes both hands. to put around these, and I hardly look like I even touched this spot. So I took in this spot here, I actually took probably 50% bulbs, and the other 50% I actually just cut, only because it's such a small patch. If it was a bigger patch, like I said, depending on what you're using it for, if you want the bulbs and you want that bigger part. But with the pickling recipe, I'm gonna just throw them all into the pickle recipe. I'm not just gonna go out with the smaller ones, but it is recommended that you use the smaller ones and not the big ones for your pickled recipe. So again, it's all up to you on and how they turn out. But now I am going to go pick some more from a transplanted patch that my parents planted years ago, and we're gonna go, let's head out there now and show you how those have grown just over the years, just by transplanting. Take you know, a half dozen plants or more. You don't want to take a whole lot, and transplant them close together, somewhere in a wooded area. It would be best away from pine trees or any type of conifer tree, in a mixed hardwoods. I'm just right behind my mom and dad's house. I'm literally just right inside the woods from the yard. My mom and dad planted these ramps years ago. I'm not specific on how long ago, but these things really took off just from a few plants. And you can see them all down and through there. Oh, I just looked down. And there's some growing over here too. So they are actually starting to spread out. I gotta get through this mess to get back there. There used to be some apple trees here, you can see, that are dying. But one thing to know is this isn't even the typical spot that you would normally plant where they would normally grow, I guess you could say. But one thing that they like, again, rich organic matter, hardwoods, and it's well-drained soil. So they're near a little stream. They're not in the water. It's not swampy here, but it's got, it's kind of like there's a ditch that runs down through here that actually has very little to no water in it. There's another little stream. You can hear the water trickling over here, and they're right in this little point between these two little ditches and little waterways. And it's a little bit of a raised up spot, so the water can fall off real fast. The water isn't gonna lay here. Perfect place to plant ramps. Got a nice little patch of ramps. They have not taken any ramps from this patch since they planted. So I'm gonna be the first one to pick these ramps. And that's the thing, they take a really long time to grow out like that. So plant them now and wait some years, and you're gonna have that. Now you can notice there's some skunk cabbage and stuff growing around in here, which there's a pile of it over there. You don't want to try to plant it where the skunk cabbage grows, but we've been having some really wet years. I used to play in this area when I was a kid and didn't really have too many skunk cabbage up on this little side bank. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna try to find some of the biggest, bulkiest plants. So you can see how this one here, it's all by itself away from the other ones. But I'm gonna look for those types, but I'm gonna try to take some out of the middle. I don't wanna take some like here. Here's some that are growing up out away from the rest of these. I want those ones to be left alone. So I'm gonna try to take a few out of the middle just sporadically. notice how these ramps all have like a reddish purplish stem that comes down to it. And right beside it, these ones do not. So again, the basic rule of thumb, because there are those other lookalikes, is to make sure that when you're picking them, they smell like onion or garlic. Okay, so it doesn't necessarily mean it has to smell good. There are other plants out there that smell good, but it has to have that garlicky onion smell. And so if you're ever looking at something like these two look a little different, again, do the nose test. But again, I can't stress enough that do not be going out into the woods blindly just saying, well, I think I know what it looks like and I'm going to pick it, and then get on there and going, well, I'm going to ask some people first before I eat this. No, if you're going to pick, you should know what you're picking before you pick it. So please research, study before you go out. As you can see, it doesn't even really look like I did anything. Look how many I got. I mean, that is a really good, I don't know if I can get them all in one hand. That is a lot right there. And it's taken little bit by little bit. Now I could probably take a little bit more, but you don't want to make it visibly, like as you're done, you look back and like, boy, I definitely can tell there isn't much here left. But that's not the way this is. You can see that patch still looks very plentiful. That's what you want to do. Then you can get multiple patches located and take from different patches. And that's the best way to do it. All right, now we got our ramps. Now let's go pickle them. Got a really great recipe for you. All right, so we're ready to pickle our ramps. Shout out to Ryan Strips for this recipe. So leave a comment down below, say, hey, thanks, Ryan. All right, here's what you're gonna need. So we want 1 cup of apple cider vinegar, 1 cup of white vinegar, 1 cup of water, 1/2 cup of sugar, 1/4 cup of canning salt, 2 tablespoons of pickling spice, and we're gonna put that in a quart jar. Now we just need to prep our ramps. So we're just gonna run some cold water. We're just gonna take our ramps. We're just gonna clean, get some of that stuff down to the base so that we bring everything down to the bottom. Then we can just snip that right off. So just gonna go through, clean some of these ramps. We're not gonna do them all at one time, just so that we have some room. Clean out all the dirt that you can find. We're just gonna set them right here in a pile, and then we'll just keep going the whole way through. Once we get our ramps cleaned out, we're just gonna come right here, right towards the base, and just cut the end off right there. So we have a good, clean cut. Then we're gonna come out here right where the stem meets, where they split, and we're gonna cut that off right there. So you can use these leaves in anything else that you want. All right, I'm 3/4 of the way done. You can see how I cut them, and you can see how much further up, you know, a little bit past the Y. You don't want to get too much of the leafy stuff. So get your jar, you can just start layering these in there. All right, the jar is full. Trying to get as many in there, I can't get them. Don't want them peeking out over the top. We're gonna add our 1 cup apple cider vinegar. 1 cup of white vinegar, 1 cup of water. Okay, our half a cup of sugar. Quarter cup of canning salt. And 2 tablespoons of pickling spice. We're gonna bring that to a boil. I'm just gonna stir this around as it try to get that salt and sugar dissolved. All right, once we bring it to a boil, it's ready to go in the jar. All right, so now that we've poured it in there, we want to make sure we have this pushed down so that nothing's sticking up. We also want to make sure we have a very clean top part of the lid so that there's no juices or anything on it. Then we can put our lid on. You hold that because that's going to be hot. Get a good tight seal on that. After you got a good seal, we want to put this in the refrigerator, and we want to at least let this settle in the refrigerator for at least 5 days. So let it soak into it for almost a week. And then try. So give it some time. So as soon as you put that in there, let it sit for a little bit and then put it in the fridge and it'll be ready to go in 5 days. So don't leave yet. We're gonna try it out. All right, it's been 5 days. Actually, it's been a little over 5 days. And we have them ready to go. Lid is sealed, turned a little pinkish color inside. And now let's open them up. Give them a try. Smells good. Try a small one right now. I think they're pretty good. These are really good. Definitely recommend trying this recipe. Again, go out there, pick yourself some ramps now that you know what to look for. And there's a lot in there. These will last quite a long time. Just keep them in the fridge. And, well, I don't know if they'll last that long because they're pretty good. So, all right, hope you guys enjoyed this video.